We want to solve the following problem graphically using the graphing calculator. NASA launches a rocket at t equals 0 seconds. Its height in meters above sea level as a function of time is h of t equals negative 4.9 t squared plus 310 t plus 332. We want to assume that the rocket will splash down in the ocean. We want to answer two questions. What time will the rocket splash into the ocean? And how high above sea level will the rocket reach? There's a couple of things we should recognize right away. First, we have a quadratic function which forms a parabola or U-shape, and since the leading coefficient is negative, the parabola opens down and would look something like this. Next, the function value when t is equal to 0 is going to be 332, so the rocket starts 332 meters above sea level. And then we assume it's going to go up, reach a high point, come back down, and splash into the ocean. So let's see if we can graph this function on the graphing calculator and then answer these two questions. One of the challenging parts about graphing this on the graphing calculator is adjusting the window to get a nice view of the function. So we're going to press y equals, clear out any old functions, type in our new function. Instead of t, we'll use x. So negative 4.9, x is this key here, squared is this key here, plus 310x plus 332. Now let's adjust the window by pressing the window key. Remember, x represents the time and y represents the height of the rocket. So let's start the time at, let's say, I don't know, negative 10. Let's go out to 60 seconds, which would be 1 minute. And we have to adjust these again. We'll change the x scale to 10. That means there'll be a tick mark every 10 units. And then for the y values, we know the y-intercept is 332, so we're going to have a pretty large y maximum. Let's start with a y minimum of, let's say, negative 500. And then we'll go, let's say, a maximum of 6,000. Again, if this doesn't work, we can always come back and adjust it. Let's change the y scale to 500. And now we'll press graph. And this window looks pretty good, but let's go ahead and extend the x maximum further so we can see where this parabola crosses the x-axis for a second time. So we'll press window. Let's go ahead and change the 60 to 70. And press graph. Now that we have the graph, I think it's going to be fairly straightforward to interpret this. The rocket starts at a height here at the y-intercept, which is 332. As time passes, it reaches a maximum height here at the vertex of the parabola. Then it starts to come back down, and this x-intercept here represents when the rocket splashes into the ocean, because the height would be 0 or 0 meters above sea level. So for this first question, what time will the rocket splash into the ocean? We actually want to find the x value or t value, which would be this intercept here. So on the calculator, we're going to press second trace, and then the x-intercepts are the zeros, so we're going to press number 2. Now it's asking us for the left bound and right bound, so we're going to move this cursor very close to this x-intercept, but just to the left of it, which in this case would be above it. Maybe somewhere in here, we'll press enter, and now it's going to ask for the right bound, which in this case is going to be just below the x-intercept. So we'll press the right arrow until the cursor is below the x-intercept. It's hard to tell, but this is below. Notice how the y value is negative, so we've crossed the x-axis. Press enter, and then enter one more time. So now we can see at the bottom here that the x-intercept is approximately 64.3, which means the rocket will splash into the ocean after approximately 64.3 seconds. Next, we want to know how high above the sea level will the rocket reach. So going back to our graph, remember the y values represent the height, so the vertex of this high point here would be the highest point above sea level that the rocket reaches. So now we're going to press second trace again for the calculation menu, and now select option 4 for maximum. And now to find that point, we have to place the cursor to the left and then to the right of the vertex. Now I'll press the left arrow until we're over to the left of the vertex. Maybe somewhere in here. Press enter. Move it back to the right side of the vertex. Maybe somewhere in here. Press enter. And then enter one more time. So here are the coordinates of the vertex. The question only asks for the height of the rocket, which would be the y coordinate, or approximately 5,235.1. And the x value represents how long it takes to reach that point, which is approximately 31.63 seconds. But again, our question only asks for the height. So here's how we can solve this problem using technology. In the next video, we'll take a look at how we can solve this by hand using what we know about quadratic functions and quadratic equations.